Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, we're going to look at a different type of audio product. We're going to look at the microphone from Sennheiser. This is the new MKE-200. So I thought I'd give this a look because I recently picked up the new Sony ZV-1 that I plan to use for YouTube videos. Shoots in 4K, and it should be much better because there's more glass than my iPhone that I'm shooting with right now. So I thought, you know, let's improve the video and also improve the audio. So let's take a quick look around the box first. First thing first, when you buy a Sennheiser product, you want to make sure that you look at the authenticity sticker. This is a very unique sticker, as you can see. So make sure your product is truly a Sennheiser and not a counterfeit. So what comes in the box? And then the technical specifications. What I like about this microphone, from what I've done in terms of research, is that it is self-powered. So that's really convenient. I don't have to worry about charging the battery or anything like that. So here's some information about the microphone. And then, so it comes with everything you need, I believe. So let's take my trusty blade. Go this way so I don't cut my fingers. Alright, so you're presented with a nice setup tutorial here. It's just a quick start guide, looks like. Rather simple, not much to it. This is the feedback, I guess, and then I guess you can download an app or something. So this looks to be a owner's manual. Tells you the frequency response as well. Very cool. Here's the microphone itself. So the housing here feels to be aluminum, metal, because it's cold. And then you got the hot shoe mount and the screw for the hot shoe. Little carrying pouch, and then a wind. This is called a windscreen, and then the folks in the business calls it a dead cat. I like that Sennheiser is paying attention to environmentally correct, not using any zip ties or anything plastic. Everything's paper now, so I appreciate that. So here's the cable. So this is a locking mechanism. So it locks onto the microphone itself so it doesn't get pulled away accidentally. This is a sort of a pro feature so that, you know, you don't accidentally disconnect the microphone. So here is a label, shows you. I recommend you to keep this label on to remind you of what it does. This is for smartphone because this is a 4-pole TRRS connector. And then you have a second cable, which is a TRS. This is a 3-pole cable. So this is a standard headphone jack that does not have the microphone line. So you can use this with your camera, your DSLR, or you can use this stereo jack with any camcorder or camera because it's just a 2-channel stereo jack. And then you mount the microphone on the hot shoe, so you just gotta remove this plate. And then you slide it on and you just tighten it up. So of course you can mount it in either direction. So if I am shooting a video with a camera lens pointing this way and I'm talking behind the camera, of course you want to mount the microphone in reverse. And then if you are doing a vlog style, then you want to mount the microphone pointing the lens side. Now, what you can use, which a lot of people have not mentioned, is with your cell phone camera grip that I have, also have a hot shoe mount. So you just push it in like this and tighten it. And then you can mount your cell phone directly on this, and then you connect it to your cell phone's audio jack or even the lightning. So if you, in the case of the cell phone, your iPhone or something, you do want to use the smartphone cable. So another thing you can do is using this stand and the microphone pointing at you. You connect this to your laptop. So when you're on a work call or a Zoom call or a FaceTime, whatever it is, so you can have much better audio quality than not using the internal microphone of your laptop. All right, so this is an audio test of the Sony ZV-1 video camera internal microphone. This is an audio test of the Sony ZV-1 video camera internal microphone, and we're comparing it against the Sennheiser MKE-200. In the next video, we're gonna listen to the MKE-200 connected to the Sony ZV-1. All right, so this is an audio sample test of the Sennheiser MKE-200 mounted on the Sony ZV-1 connected to the Sony's internal microphone input. So we're listening to the Sennheiser MKE-200 microphone connected to the Sony ZV-1. All right, so this is the audio test using the internal microphone of my 12.9 fourth generation newest iPad Pro, comparing the audio test using the internal microphone versus the Sennheiser MKE-200, which is coming up next. Again, this is an audio test of the iPad Pro's internal studio microphone. All right, so this is an audio test of the Sennheiser MKE-200 microphone directly connected to my 12.9 inch latest iPad Pro's USB-C connector using Apple's USB-C adapter. Again, this is an audio test of the microphone using an iPad Pro, so you can compare the sound quality between the iPad Pro's studio microphone versus the Sennheiser. All right, so the last portion of this video, I'm gonna record it with my iPhone with the Sennheiser MKE-200 mounted right above it and using the grip that I showed you in the video. And let me know your thoughts with this video, which microphone sounds better, the iPad's internal studio quality microphone or the Sennheiser, or the Sony ZV-1's internal microphone or the Sennheiser. Let me know in the comments. I appreciate you watching my videos, and I'll see you guys again in my next one. Bye-bye.